meeting order. It is the October 17, 2016 meeting of the Committee on Community Resources. And we are being audio and video recorded. Pam, would you like to call the roll?
Counselor Bidwell?
Here.
Counselor Carney?
Present.
Counselor Klein?
Here.
Counselor Sharon?
Here. I do not see any public for public comment, which is the first time I think ever for this committee. So we will move on to the approval of the minutes from September 19th, 2016. Is there a motion?
I would move approval of those minutes of September 19th.
Is that a second?
I have a comment.
I'll second.
Discussion?
There's a sentence here that I would like altered if at all possible, because it seems to convey that I wasn't in support of a particular thing that we discussed because of the language of how it was recorded. Just have to find it. Sorry, I was trying to find it before the meeting started. It's about the CPA funding and working to get the CPA funding available for the arts.
Top of page 3, maybe? Seems to be what we're talking about. Or bottom of page 2, top of page 3.
Yeah, so there's something that says that Councillor Klein feels like it's not in our jurisdiction. But I want to make clear that the council can't alter, and I think I said that in my comments, the council is not able to alter the purpose of CPA funds, that has to happen at the state legislative level. So it's not within our jurisdiction, but I am supportive of if it's identified by arts organizations that they think we should move forward in advocating for that we advocate for it. So if that could kind of be in that same sentence, I would really appreciate it, because I don't want it on record
in the
that
top
I
of page 3.
Support the.
Okay.
Because it says, and is more appropriate at the state house level. So that makes it sound like I'm kind of washing our hands of it, and that's clearly not how I feel about it. Thank you. That was my one issue.
Anybody else have any?
Excellent job. Thorough job, as always.
Yes, Pam. Thank you.
Okay.
Yep.
So with that amendment from Councillor Klein, all those in favor of approving minutes?
Aye.
Aye.
Objections and abstentions? Okay, so those are approved. Okay, so moving on to the next item on the agenda, nothing was referred to us, so we are, for the rest of our meeting, continuing to go over sort of the information we received from the Community Center request and figure out our next steps with it. So with that in mind, we have two things that you should all have. One is, so at the end of our meeting last time, it was decided that Pam and I would go through, you know, we've kind of taken the list that Jonathan Goldman had condensed, and then further, based on the discussion that we had about everything on that list, kind of break it down into sort of action categories. So things, you know, sort of our thoughts on what we were gonna, ways to move forward with those things. So you have from us a committee, Sawyer Press and Downtown Economy, findings condensed into working areas sheets. And it was also, we also talked about that Councillor Bidwell and I were going to talk about, you know, also talk about this further and figure out, you know, if there was sort of a path we could lay out. And so we did meet, and he came up with this memo that you all have as well. So
on one page.
On one page, both of them on one page. Which, you know, I gotta say, like, I'm pretty impressed that we were able to get this all done in one page. So looking at the condensed findings condensed into working areas, what Pam and I came up with was support legislation or other council initiatives, op-ed/resolutions, which is sort of our way to say ways that we can indicate support from within the committee, and refer to other agencies or committees, convene an expert panel. And so under support legislation or other initiatives, we have the idea that we were just talking about exploring the CPA fund feasibility, and food trucks. So reviewing our ordinance and to see if we can get it to be modified. Then ways to indicate support, the shop local, support local message, support downtown shopping as an experience, emphasize continued support for the tax factor of one, a message that doesn't always kind of get out there, especially since we just did that, there was no press about it. Convey message on retail rents, support for continued conversation around fair wages that was started in this committee, promote programs that already exist for small business, and support efforts to increase Amtrak service and commuter rail. Then things to potentially refer to other agencies or committees, second floor business visibility, signs and things like that, the cost of those, that kind of visibility, which I think is actually already, is being talked about in the wayfaring discussion, wayfinding. I always get this wrong. The wayfinding discussions.
You mean the sandwich boards or?
Right.
Okay.
Like sandwich boards or if there are other ways to draw attention to second floor businesses, things like that. And I think that's part of that discussion that's happening. Research where liquor license revenue goes. There was a lot of talk from the public about trying to figure out whether we could use that revenue for lights or things like that. So I'm not sure that's possible, but looking into that more. Reviewing the loading zone ordinance, which we've heard a bit about, just figuring out ways that people can load in and out without getting tickets. And along those lines, also the appeals process for tickets when you get them. So both of those seem like they're transportation and parking issues. The PBTA board, the idea that maybe there needs to be a council representation in addition to the mayor's representation on that board. And convening an expert panel, or another sort of, you know, public discussion. One for at-risk people downtown, which would encompass the conversations about panhandling and busking and things like that. An arts one to talk about the CPA feasibility again, or we heard a lot about trying to find ways to promote more events and ways to draw people in. And so bringing together different groups to talk about that and figure out how we could all work together and use the public space and resources that we have. And focus session to consider ideas brought forward to boost the downtown economy. This is sort of along those same lines. Festivals, programming at Pulaski Park, pop-ups, things like that. Also the last being what to be done to promote tourism, sort of all along those same lines, ways to bring people downtown. So that's what Pam and I came up with. And then Councillor Bidwell, would you like to talk about your memo that you sent out?
Sure. I definitely see it as tracking with the work you and Pam did in breaking this down into areas. I found myself thinking about some of these meaty areas and wanting to just put something on the table as a something to react to see if we can go forward. And I guess two of them are fall into that convene an expert panel. I think that there's enough overlap between festivals, arts, tourism promotion, that your bullets 2 and 3, I think, kind of start to largely come together. And I think there is a readiness for a number of groups who recognize that they kind of coordinate, but they're never all in the same room quite at the same time. I do think there might be some merit in encouraging a panel of this group of folks that would then, having shared ideas, perhaps become a working group going forward. And I had a similar thought on the at-risk folks downtown and the panhandling issue, where I definitely sense there's a readiness to tackle it. Not to go back to the world of ordinance possibilities. I don't find much hunger for that. But I do think non-ordinance approaches, there's a lot of good ideas floating around out there among the social service and housing organizations. And I think there's a recognition that what we were hearing through our forums is representative of a lot of feeling out there across a broad spectrum of folks, that we need to look at solutions that are being tried in other cities and see if there's some applications there for us. So there too, I think, some kind of carefully facilitated forum that then could be a springboard to an ongoing working group. And in both instances, my idea, and I agree very much with sentiments, is we don't want to wind up in the business on an ongoing basis and deal with these issues. In a hands-on working group way, but I do think to convene groups, bless them, encourage their continuation if they see fit, I do think there would be some merit in that. So those were the two that fall into the convening expert panel group. And then I just noted on wage theft that I think there may be something coming, and I'm not sure what we do in the meantime as a committee beyond wait to see what it becomes as proposed ordinance or executive order. Perhaps then be supportive of that and be supportive of an appropriate resolution regarding state legislation. And then I think a lot of these other things that we learned, data that we gathered, stories that we heard, many of these bullets under op-eds, I do think will be helpful to putting out there. What we believe is the state of downtown and what is the nature of additional support that's necessary. So that's, as you can see, what I wanted to just put out there as a jumping off.
Would it be helpful at this point for me to give an update to, I think the minutes show that Councilor Klein and I were going to have a meeting with the mayor to talk about possible legislation. So I could give a little update there. I met with the mayor and Alan Seawald, but we did, and Jocelyn Jones also came with me to that meeting, and we talked about a possible ordinance, and tried to find out what kind of questions or concerns there might be at that level. And it's similar to other things that we've addressed as a council, in particular the separation of executive and legislative, and that became kind of a question on the part of the solicitor. He said he had to think on it, regardless of whether it was a legislative or executive matter. The mayor was comfortable with the idea of adopting policies if it meant an administrative executive level to look at contracts and procurement and tie those to a certification of wage and hour compliance. And similarly with licenses, there were some questions about licenses because it's those are concerns that the solicitor has about whether there would be legal liability. And so those are things that he was going to get back to me. Unfortunately, there was a little bit of stall there too. We wanted to speak directly to folks in Boston. And there was a mix-up there, and she got there for 10 days. And anyway, he only recently, in the last week or so, got that contact info. So I'm hoping that he had a chance to speak with Trin Nguyen in the Boston mayor's office, the ministers. They have a whole, as you've seen in the legislation that we for all in the committee, very different than what we would be proposing. We were just basically talking about linking the permits and contracts, contracts and licenses to certification of original permits. So hopefully we'll hear something back. And if it does turn out, then it would be appropriate for the council to consider a resolution, in support of state legislation, as you suggested, Councilor, but also calling on the mayor then to adopt the policies and procedures that similarly have been adopted in other states and towns. So we're kind of in a waiting state. But it would probably, I'm happy to send that rough draft that the solicitor is looking at with the understanding that it would be completely changed to be an executive order. And there were also some things were, just some matters of form that he really wanted to attend to if we do adopt something like that.
A question about the, at what level would the certification of compliance get
what's handled? Typically done is when an application comes to the city, there's a form, certification form, and that says, and that will be for the majority of our businesses and yeah, it would basically be two check boxes. One would say, I'm in compliance with Mass General Law 151E, and the other one would be, I have adjudicated findings and I have posted a wage bond. That's what's been done in Boston, Cambridge, and Chelsea. I think also in Manchester.
So it's essentially self-disclosure.
Self-disclosure. That's what I thought. I just wanted to.
Yeah, and it's what's done right now. I mean, that's how we handle the tax requirement. Certification that you're not in arrears of your taxes, and that you're holding a workers' comp policy. It's how. So it's an additional form.
Right. And if someone were to come forward with other information that has not been self-disclosed, it would be. Probably the licensing commissioner or a staff member in City Hall would be responsible for being in touch with the AG's office. This is how we initially had envisioned
this.
And then it got complicated because of the procurement piece, because it's the mayor's office that oversees all of the procurement, and that's not something that City Council gets involved in. So that's how this turned into the possibility of an executive order from the mayor's office as opposed to a council resolution.
So it would be then staff. It would be either, I think right now it's Cindy in the mayor's office that processes all the applications for licenses, and it's Joe Cook that processes all the procurement documents.
Right.
So similarly, with the plethora of documents that a vendor or a contractor has to submit, there would be this additional form. And so, it's a serious matter. I guess the question arises is what if they did on the form or something, but it's a serious matter. It's a affidavit.
Under
the person is right.
Yeah.
So, I think
language.
That
yeah.
Folks would be careful before they willingly and knowingly checked the wrong box, because that could put a contract or a license or something at risk.
And so, if. As you say, evidence of some sort of suggestion that maybe they weren't totally truthful in that certification, then Cindy or Joe Cook or somebody I just want to be clear, they're not expected to do their own investigation. They just refer to the Attorney General's office at that point.
Well, I think we would, I think the city would have something to say to a contractor or to a licensee who willingly, knowingly checked off that box. I mean, I think it would be a serious matter. It wouldn't be just a phone call up to the Attorney General's office if, you know, there was in fact an adjudicated case and we.
Oh, if it was adjudicated, it could be easily ascertained.
Oh, yeah, right. Well, yeah, okay.
But if it's something that required some independent.
Investigation.
Who's telling the truth here?
No investigatory.
Right, or hearing, right.
The only time too that it would, that a call to the AG's office would be triggered would be if in fact somebody came forward to City Hall or it came to light that there was in fact a wage, a claim of wage theft on a particular contractor or vendor that hadn't, that had checked off that they didn't have any adjudications. We would then, a staff person at City Hall would have to be in touch with the AG's office.
Yeah, there'd be some flexibility, you know, with it.
Well, there's always some discretion.
Right.
To sort out the totally frivolous from the apparently serious.
And it would give us the opportunity, the city staff would then be able to say to the AG's office when it came to that, that this case or that had merit and it would make sense for you to follow through on these. So. It establishes, but a lot of this is, it establishes a stronger relationship with the city and the AG's office.
Mm-hmm. And particularly a company, if a company with more investigative resources at the AG's office, then you really got something.
Right.
I mean, I think what this can do for the community more broadly is if we were to pass a resolution as a council in support of an executive order to get the word out, to do some publicity around it so that people who may have dealt with a wage theft issue would know to actually in fact file a complaint so that that would go to the AG's office, adjudication process would start. And it's just a way to kind of make people more aware of the issue and to actually file complaints should wage theft happen. So I think that's the role that we can play with our resolution as a council.
Mm-hmm. That's very helpful. And yeah, if you're circulating something.
Yeah, I have that. Happy to share that.
Curious to go.
With the understanding that it's not going to probably be that. In any event, even if it is an ordinance from delivered to the council, it would be changed to form, and that's what's called a rough draft. I'm happy to send it along.
Got it. Okay, so are there other thoughts about these working areas or ways to go forward? Or yeah, Council Klein, I see you nodding.
Yeah, I have. A few thoughts about what Councilor Bidwell, you put together here. I so appreciate it. I think it's really good thinking. I do think, though, that for the two places where you suggest convening meetings, the arts and the panhandling and kind of general well-being, I think, of at-risk folks who are downtown, that I want us to be careful that we're not kind of making assumptions about what the agencies involved and the organizations involved have or haven't done yet. And that I suspect that in both of these realms, all of the disparate organizations have forums within which they meet regularly and talk amongst themselves. And so if we're convening something as a council, I think it would have to have a particular angle. First of all, we'd have to check with them if they're really interested in doing this so that we're, of course, not stepping on toes, but that it would have to have a particular angle around the topic of conversation that we would want to get at is, you know, what role might the council play? What might you as organizations want us to do to continue to advocate for whatever your issues, concerns are? And to make it unique in that sense, so it's not just, you know, kind of enforcing some kind of or convening something that they've already got in place and are already doing. But also I'm wondering if, you know, I know we don't want to deal endlessly with the report, but I am wondering if we were to convene something like this, if it would make sense for, and it ends up being some kind of convening that goes on, is ongoing with these organizations, that a representative of this committee might want to be a member of whatever that convening is and work as a liaison back and forth to the convening folks and our committee so that we can continue to have this conversation about, you know, what might we as a council do, as a committee, and then maybe as a council do. So those are just a few tweaks, I think, to what you're suggesting.
Actually, I don't take them as tweaks. I take them as very much in line with what I was thinking about. But in my effort to get it on one page, but I made a passing reference to before either of these panels or any panel would go forward, you'd need to put together a working group to really think it through and get clear on what it is we're trying to do here. And clearly, a representative from this committee would want to be on such a working group and might discover after one working group session, nice idea, council, but we've got it. I think there's a good chance that in fact there would be welcome. But you're absolutely right. We would want a small group of folks working, you know, outside of this arena to talk it through and think about, you know, would this indeed make sense? And then I would agree it might make sense if it's an effort that lives on and goes forward, that it would make sense for there to be a liaison if the group wanted it, knowing that all of us have other things to move on to. We don't want to get endlessly involved in this, but I think a liaison on an ongoing basis. So no, I your suggestions are very much in line with where I was headed, but didn't necessarily very completely describe.
And you know, just to be clear, with either of these sort of ideas that we're talking about, you know, if it's going to involve people from city departments, whether it's Peg Keller or the Arts Council, whatever, we would meet with the mayor beforehand to discuss these ideas and try to figure out how we bring in city departments in addition to outside organizations. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I just want to say really quickly, I think that there's kind of a separation between the report and what comes out of the report and what is the purview of this committee anyway. So, you know, we might want to kind of move on from the work mandated by this report, but if we were in fact to liaise with committees or that seems to me just kind of a no-brainer because it's part of what the purview of this committee to be involved with things like the arts and the health of downtown, and I mean it's the whole community resources mandate. So absolutely.
Yep.
Okay, other thoughts? So how should we proceed? Anyone have opinions on that? Do we want to brainstorm who would be involved in these groups and then set up a meeting with the mayor?
Oh, can I add one more? I know that, back to in the topic of wage theft that wasn't included in, we'll say, this rough draft, but the concerns brought up by the carpenters about some problems that they had with a contractor up on Hospital Hill that had received a tip. So it raised the question about whether or not we want to have some of these policies adopted in our tip language and CPA. I mean, do we want to have conditions on recipients of CPA funds if they're contractors? I'm just saying those are a couple of concerns that carpenters brought up in the forums that we have that aren't really addressed that well in that legislation. I know that TIF language itself has been a concern. I know there is a published document, but it's something that could probably we could take a look at. I know it's the mayor's, but then we can make some recommendations around that, at least in that context.
Ultimately, whether it's CPA funding or if there's a TIF involved, there's some contract entered into by the city. So in the type of executive order that you're imagining, could it be included there? It doesn't matter whether it's CPA funds or out of the general fund, if it's a contract or procurement.
But yeah, that may well be that it'd be covered by
regardless of the source of the
guidelines. Yeah, maybe. But I think we do have a document that's TIF guidelines as well.
It's
well, for CPA, there have been CPA funds for private, like historic buildings that would
for a developer too, I think, for that Gresham, oh, which for the Christopher Heights. That was a CPA.
True, but who actually is a signatory on the city's behalf on the contract for spending the dollars of the CPA funds? I mean, I'm assuming ultimately. Ultimately, whether it's CPA funds or funds from a bond issue or general fund dollars, that's the source, but they still go through a similar contracting procurement process. I'm asking as a question. But in any event, that could be.
Well, I mean, if we do have a document that's published, I think we do. I haven't seen it in the document that was on Edmund. Then we could look at that document and see if it addresses that issue. It's certainly brought for our TIF, I'm not sure about the CPA.
Right. I mean, for example, like the work done on the windows for First Churches. That's that would be an example where it's not.
True, but there's some paperwork between the city when the dollars flow from the city mm-hmm. to First Churches.
Right.
That's the opportunity to put my agent.
Yeah.
Anyway, something to look at.
Okay. Yeah. So, referring back to the list that Pam and I put together, what are people's thoughts on this? So, and how would we go forward? So, in terms of, let's, for example, looking at the sort of op-ed/resolution ways to indicate our support. Is this, I'm just trying to lay out what our next steps are, as I always am. So how should we go forward with these working areas that we've now identified to start working on them?
You have another hard copy of the list.
Oh, sorry.
Can you email it? Because I don't remember receiving it.
No, I think I just tried to give you one when you come in.
I thought it was just the agenda.
No,
we have a lot. Great. Thank you.
And what it all means, and he had suggested that if we were to address some of these topics, as you suggest here, in some combination of op-eds and supportive resolutions, that we might want to wait till he's got year-end data.
Okay.
Which would suggest that piece of it could wait until after the start of the year.
Okay.
Of course, there are some of these messages that certainly aren't dependent on updated data, but some would be reinforced with that data. And actually, I I meant to print it out, but I noticed we got quarterly revenue reports from Susan Wright, and I just glanced at them. The hotel and meals tax revenue numbers continue to be very encouraging. And I think that's the kind of data that really adds texture to whatever we're saying, is that there's stories and there's data. Here's one measure of what's going on. So some of it we could put out now, some of it we could wait.
Okay. If we were to wait to work on that until maybe after the year, new year, what would be the next thing that we tackle?
I think that it might make some sense sooner rather than later to have this conversation with the mayor.
Right, that's what I was thinking.
Both with, you know, with regard to his department's involvement in the downtown at-risk folks forum, whatever, however we describe it, as well as the arts promotion events forum. I would like to think he'd be receptive to the argument that it'd be silly to have this stuff going forward without city involvement. But I think, and to also get his blessing for, you know, Terry continuing to provide us with some data and some availability this time, and just generally get mayoral buy-in into what we're doing here. I would think that might be an important next step. And if he would see it that way, then one would hope that one of his staffers, Ned Keller, is the obvious person, might be made available to help with this working group that we're imagining. On the arts downtown events promotion type of gathering, Suzanne Beck has been talking about this idea with a number of folks, DNA, I don't know about Arts Council, but Center for the Arts and an Academy, and she tells me that there would be support for this, and she would be willing to play a role in helping to convene, perhaps even facilitate a working group meeting to plan a forum. If we as a committee think that there's merit in proceeding there.
Okay. So I'm happy to set up a meeting to discuss this with the mayor. Obviously, we can't all go to it, unfortunately, because of open meeting law. So, we could have an initial meeting to sort of present this idea, and then we could invite him to come to our next meeting if everyone would like to talk to him about it. How do people feel about that? Or just have a meeting and get his thoughts.
I think you can go forward with the meeting.
I think where there's an opportunity to kind of move the process along at a more rapid pace, if there's consensus here, that makes sense.
All right.
That's fine with me. I just, I'm also thinking though that I'm not sure what other kind of business we're going to have referred to us as a committee. And I think that, you know, at a certain point we can say that we are closing down this study per se. And that maybe we could, from month to month, have a different theme of our meetings and tackle some of these things just more bite-sizably. Because I think part of what makes me feel overwhelmed and a little bit paralyzed is when I look at all the lists that we've generated and all the different topics. Yeah, they're one page, but I think they're pretty meaty areas, and there's a lot we could figure out to do with them. So I'm just wondering if we could maybe just approach some of these things that way. Just think that, you know, November will be whatever month, Transportation Month, the next week. What, and just as a way to kind of proceed with this, because I feel like there's a lot to chew over in each of these bullet points. I don't know. That's just a suggestion because I'm feeling overwhelmed by it.
Mm-hmm. And do you mean more about, because you mentioned transportation.
Yeah, I don't know why that one came in.
Okay.
But, yeah.
Do you mean more of this sort of like talking about how we want to indicate our support for things? Or do you mean like maybe November we should, you know, talk, you know, report on the meeting with the mayor, but then talk in depth about like what, you know, who do we want to invite to a, you know, a, for this panel or working group for, you know, at, people who are at risk downtown or for the arts, you know, promotion.
Yeah, I was thinking of it in terms of the different topics that we have here.
Okay.
Is that clarifying?
It is. I just thinking about some of these topics. I'm not sure if there is there enough for like a meeting on it.
Well, presumably we'd have some other things to deal with in our meeting, or we could set it up where we have, you know, two per meeting or something like that, and then because I would imagine that out of any of these, just about there would end up being some. Operationalizable kinds of tasks that one or two counselors would take on as we move forward, and that would mean at the next meeting there might be a report back. But just so that we can have a feeling that we're getting to each of these and giving them their due, it seems like a good way to break it down.
Okay. So should we pick one or two for next meeting?
I mean, I don't know if people.
I think it would be helpful to have a subject to change. Obviously, a 3 or 4 or 5 month kind of roadmap.
Mm-hmm.
And one possibility would be that in November we talk about what we've, you know, hopefully, you know, there might by that point be some progress in with these working groups planning these. Panels or whatever, so we might be able to report back on that. And there are, you mentioned transportation. Well, there are, you know, there are several of these issues: the parking ticket issue, the PVTA board representation issue. Actually, you know, we the possible and an update on passenger rail. I mean, there's a number of things that sort of cluster in.
Are you volunteering?
No, I think it should actually be another transportation
yeah,
park.
Really? Is that what you're going to say?
No, but I'm just saying we could tick off some of those, and some of those are just inquiries or sent out. It doesn't even have to, in some cases, involve anybody here. And then maybe by December, the working group would be ready for a meeting. I guess we haven't really talked about whether we see these panels as being at meetings of this committee.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe by December, the working group working on the downtown at-risk / panhandling issue would be ready to roll out that form in December. Maybe the working group working on arts and forum and festivals and promotion would be ready to do their forum in January or February. Maybe January, when we have year-end data from Terry, we talk more substantively about what goes into this op-ed piece that we want to put up.
Right.
Another organizational possibility could be that each of the four of us is assigned to a particular realm, and that we, as a group today and maybe next month, we identify what the legwork is that needs to be done for the designated counselor to then go out and kind of figure the pieces out. I mean, I'm thinking, for instance, one person could be responsible for the arts piece. One could be responsible for the at-risk downtown folks. And the legwork might be contacting all of the possible suspects, you know, that should be part of the forum to ask if they're even interested, or do they already have a forum that they meet where we could be an add-on. And then, so just, because it can take a month to kind of be in touch with all of the individuals involved. One person could be responsible for the transportation related ones, and that would mean probably calling Nancy Forrestal and calling the mayor's office and finding out information and then bringing that back to the next meeting. And that might just be a way, because I feel like there's a lot of legwork here, and it's hard for us in the meetings to kind of get anything done because so much of it needs to kind of happen through conversations outside of this room.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'm just kind of bringing my community organizing background to this, you know,
no,
like how do we actually like make something happen?
I agree, and I had in mind such a division of, that's, you're right, that's the only way it's going to get done. Councilor Plaza, when you see yourself wanting to take on?
I would love to do the arts one, but it might be popular, so we could shoot it out or something.
I've done some of these preliminary conversations on the downtown at-risk companion piece. Could continue with that one.
Okay.
Unless someone else would want to take that one.
And so by taking these on, explain to me what this means at this point.
I think that, I mean, we could use more time in this meeting to kind of identify what the next steps are that each counselor needs to do. And then I'm sure other things will kind of unfold as we start making phone calls or whatever, but we could start with the preliminary list. That makes sense. I mean, we're just kind of playing around with ideas here. We're kind of brainstorming, so it might not work, but maybe it could. I mean, it seems to me that some of the other topics are the wage theft piece, which Councilor Carney is already very engaged with, and I don't know if it feels like enough or if you'd be interested in taking that on and maybe something else. We do have the transportation kind of related things, which, sorry to say, Councilor Shara, it kind of does make sense because you've got your other foot in the TPC.
Mm-hmm, that's fine.
And then there's, I think one of the biggest ones is kind of what appears under op-eds, which is kind of all the downtown business related stuff. So, you know, we're already beyond four major topics here. We're moving into five, probably six here. See, there's tourism, but that kind of can fit under business, right?
Business and the arts and events. Mm. It certainly has a major tourism component too.
But then kind of there are these little outliers that are kind of their own topics, which are like food trucks or pop-up food events or arts events. You know, all of that fits broadly, I think, under the whole business piece, so maybe we have to think about how to, maybe each of us takes on two things, one broader topic and then maybe one specific, like, you know, one person could take on food trucks and find out more about that. And
I'll look into the food trucks.
All right.
So I just want to just recap a statement that you made in the committee study request report that you had put together. You had said that you'll work to determine if there are any practical recommendations and or legislation that we can bring back to the full city council to strengthen the local economy as directed by the CSR. Were you going to do the recommendations before you started?
Well, I mean, I think you bring up a good point, which is that, you know, we've done this preliminary report, but we, although I'm not sure that it's necessarily expected, I do feel like we need to do sort of a subsequent report that says, these are the steps that we're taking. I don't think it needs to be, you know, this, we did these things and this is what, you know, culminated. I think we can say, you know, having collected, that report was really about like how we collected the data and what we, and that process. And then I feel like we could write a report that says, you know, out of meeting about, you know, looking at all of everything that we've collected, we came up with these, you know, these four different working areas we're going to do, and we're pursuing this, and I feel like that could, you know, if we make a report that says the direction we're going in with this, that could close out the CSR.
You know, perhaps out of that, though, out of those recommendations, you know, the council president might assign some of the work to other councilors or other committees.
I see where you're going with this.
So our recommendations could be something more like, these are the topics that came out of the series of hearings and our discussions. These are the ones that we want to pursue and or encourage more study around. And then submit them for discussion with the council president. Is that what you're thinking? To see if there's somebody outside of this committee that it would be more appropriate to be handled, and so we shouldn't kind of do those assignments now?
Well, I just think there's a lot here for one committee to sort of tackle when there's four other committees that...
Right, and that's sort of how Councilor O'Donnell had described it, too.
Over to the TPC, boom.
or we write a report that says, you know, these are the things we heard, you know, we recommend that it's taken up by the TPC, we recommend that the ordinance for food trucks be reviewed to see if it can be modified. We work, you know.
I mean, and that could be done by legislative matters.
True.
You know, review of ordinances, you know what I mean?
Right.
To see if they're appropriate, if they're too, you know, binding or whatever.
Right.
I guess my only fear, I think that's an awesome idea. Thank you so much, Pam. I'm just worried that if we as a commission or committee or committee don't continue to kind of hold the overarching vision and know that, you know, this is being referred here, but we're kind of checking in and making sure that something actually unfolds with it. So I want to kind of maintain, I don't know if that makes sense to you as the chair and vice chair, I guess, but that we maintain some level of responsibility. I mean, the only thing that doesn't seem to fit under our committee exclusively to me seems like it's the parking and transportation stuff, but things that have to do with entertainment and social services and tourism and city resources seems like it's the place. So that's why I was kind of thinking originally that we would have to handle it, but.
Well, the city services does, aren't they the ones that do the
community resources.
Sorry.
We're community resources.
Right. But
no, but you're talking about city services.
City services, aren't they the ones that do?
Well, I think, I mean, I'm trying to remember if we had, I mean, as a departmental presentation, but is that pretty much what you're talking about?
Well, I thought yours was more related to zoning and housing partnership and that sort of thing.
I think that that was always a little bit of the problematic of that, of creating these two committees, is it wasn't totally clear like what fit where, because I seem to remember that city services had tourism under it. I think when Councillor O'Donnell created those concepts, I think he himself said, you know, there's some fluidity or flexibility with what, and some of the things maybe were a little bit more set in stone, but I think there was a lot that it wasn't quite clear which of the two committees things would fit under. But I think it would be a great idea if we could look at this list and refer things on to the city services if there's, you know, if there's something to give them.
You know, I only offer that up because, as you mentioned, this is a pretty meaty list and it is,
but I guess my
some of them are, I mean, when you look at it, like, almost, you can almost check, like, emphasize continued support for tax factor of one. I mean, you know, that can be done in the form of an op-ed or something at the appropriate time. We just passed the appropriate time, really, for that. But, and some stuff we know, where, you know, around the fair wages, we're kind of in this waiting game with that. So in terms of what we'd actually do, there are a few things. I think so definitely it makes sense to send some of these to transportation and parking about what's the appeals process for parking tickets and EBT board.
So do we want to send it sort of directly, or do we want to create this report in which we recommend that it be reviewed by transportation and parking, which would sort of close out the community trust? Would people like me to review what the rules say for this committee?
Sure.
It says the committee may develop, review, and recommend policies on matters including economic development, local business, tourism, the environment, the arts, planning, zoning, sustainability, land use, housing, and affordability, among others. May review and make recommendations on licenses and permits. Related departments, boards, agencies, arts council, planning and sustainability, housing authority, housing authority.
Do you have city services there too? Can you read that?
So city services may review, recommend policies on matters including public safety and public health, veterans affairs, social services, libraries,
social services,
disability, aging, and recreation, among others.
Social services, boom, there goes your at-risk.
Don't give it to city services. It doesn't belong
there.
I know, that one doesn't make sense.
It doesn't belong
there. It is yeah. Kind of an outlier.
Yeah.
I mean, my own view is one, I don't feel a need, nor do I feel the timing is quite right to go back to the council with another report and recommendations. We have a mandate and at least a little bit of momentum, and I share your view, Councilor Klein, that if we take it back to the council deliberates and defers something over here and something over there, then I think we may have lost a little something. Maybe this is a rookie mistake, but I'm not as daunted by what's in front of us. If we break it down into some discrete tasks and divide it up, and like I said, my view of these panels is there's some initial work with a working group in setting it up, and then hopefully we would have someone other than us perhaps actually facilitating, and then we've launched I don't find it as daunting, and I'm not as inclined to start parceling it out a lot of other ways, frankly.
Well, I mean, for example, in the panhandling one, if we were to have a, you know, convene an expert panel, which I'm taking these two and joining them together there, it's a very controversial topic and it's going to have a lot of interest beyond what we heard. I think we heard a lot of the business concern. But I think once it becomes something like a panel on at-risk people downtown, it brings in ACLU and a lot of other, even though we may couch it as something that's a non-ordinance, looking at non-ordinance alternatives, I think it still would bring out a lot of community participation.
It
was good then. I mean, if we're going to do something like that, we should definitely public session.
So it's 6 o'clock now. Why don't we? I mean, I just started quickly making a list. Why don't we look at these two sort of panels, working group things? Come up with a list of people that right now we think would be help. You know, would be good to have involved and would help guide this process in addition to us. And that would also help me as I meet with the mayor to say, this is sort of what our vision is, this is what we're thinking, these are the city departments we'd like to have involved. What, you know, and get his feelings on it, okay? Mm-hmm. So for the panhandling at-risk, as you just mentioned, so I'd already put down Bill Newman. I know that Peter Ives, I was just at an event with him, and he was telling me he has a fund where he like a court mandated fund that he gives $400 a month to people at risk. He would, you know, and he said there are other funds like that around. And he would be interested, he approached me about this topic, and he'd be interested in being part of a group that talks about, you know, other ways to approach dealing with people at risk downtown. Peg Keller, of course, Chief Casper.
I want to interrupt really quickly just to say, I just want to question the process here, because I think we identified one way that we might work. We had a little bit of discussion about it. Now I feel like now we're kind of focusing on just the panels. Is that the way that we've decided we want to work on this moving forward? I just want to make sure that we're
clear on our
process.
I was focusing on the panels because if I'm going to meet with the mayor, I think giving him something a little bit more fleshed out would be helpful. And then we could move forward more quickly, I thought. That's why I was focusing on that.
But then we're tackling just two of the things that we kind of have identified need to be tackled on the list. So are we not going to, because
well,
we have
also
to
dealing with, and we're in the waiting game with the wage theft stuff, so that we are still tackling.
Okay, so that's three of them being tackled.
One of the others is this cluster of topics that are sort of here under op-eds. One approach is to wait until we have a little more data and then start to tackle that through some combination of op-eds and resolutions. So I wasn't suggesting that we only focus on a couple of panels, but there are, I think, two areas that would lend themselves to panels, and those are a little more complicated in terms of lead time, so it might make sense to go in on the planning of those, knowing that sort of over here in parking for a while is the wage theft, and that we're going to wait for more data on the other clusters. So I still see them all holding together.
Seem to encompass many, many things that we heard too. So that's sort of what I was focusing on.
Okay, it felt like a shift in kind of the way we were envisioning all of our marching orders. It's totally fine with me, but I just want to make sure.
Well, and I'm happy to send, I mean, but I still feel very strongly, and we must meet with the mayor first before we involve some of these city departments. So I want to get that piece done, and then, you know, I'm happy to hand the arts one over to you and hand the, or whoever's getting whatever. But I feel like this is a step that needs to happen right away. So other ideas for
city departments, that's what you're looking at now?
Or just, and anyone to be on this list?
This is where for me it gets a little uncomfortable. As I said before, I think that it could be a bit presumptuous of us to start putting together our vision of what these panels need to look like.
These are just people to say we're interested in this, are you interested?
Right, but I think that, for instance, if you're talking about social service agencies that need to be involved, there are people that probably know a lot better than us, and they might already have somebody, a group convened that
sure.
we would drop into. So I want to be careful that we're not just all of a sudden kind of like, you know, these are the people we're going to have at the table.
These names we would generate as folks who we invite to be part of a working group that would identify who would be the right people if there is to be a panel at all. You got to start someplace. And
if we don't want to talk about people outside of city departments, that's fine. Just give me city departments so I can go to the mayor.
This is partly why I was thinking if there was somebody responsible for each of these topics, that we would. Our marching orders for next time would be to make those initial phone calls. So it would be like if just as an example, I were doing the arts, I would know that I would call Penny Burke and Richard Wagner, and I'd say, who, is there already a body that exists? Can we create an overlay that is about the city council being involved? Who already sits at the table? Is there anyone missing at that table? Because those are the people doing the work. I just want to make sure that we're being respectful of all of this, you know, community work that goes on all the time that we've been outside of. So that's really where my concern is in bringing this up.
That's totally fine. And I'm just trying to be respectful of the division of power in the city and that we can't, we must, I as the chair must approach the mayor that's in the roles to before we engage any of the city departments. So that's what I'm looking for.
And I agree with you that, you'll have a more productive conversation with the mayor if you give him a sense of what we're talking about. And I think Friends of the Homeless should be invited to participate. Apparently, someone who's become real involved in the DNA, Alan Wolf, is very much interested in these issues and would be a good person. Pam Schwartz has obvious interests, professional and personal.
Sue Stubbs from ServiceNet,
but back to city department. So I have Peg and
Terry.
I have Chief, so I have the Chief Casper, Terry.
And I'm back on panhandling downtown, I guess. And Peg.
Yes,
yeah,
so
yeah,
Peg,
I mean, I
Peg,
think
Chief
those
Casper,
are the, those
Terry.
Are the, those are the, those are the.
Okay, and then for the arts?
I wonder if someone from the planning department, especially because we're talking about redesigning downtown streets, I think that that probably means somebody from the planning department needs to be there.
Great.
Someone from the Board of Health, maybe, would be useful for that discussion. Or from the health department, I should say.
Right.
One or the other. I think that would be the mayor's call.
Okay. Moving on to the arts. Arts.
Clearly Brian.
Right, so Brian. So the Arts Council, Brian.
And Parks and Rec is responsible for the last year.
And I think Terry, it would make sense to have Terry Masterson there as well.
Yeah. Planning as well, maybe?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they're, you know, they're setting up this in Cracker Barrel Alley, that,
right.
You know, that
right.
they're organizing that
right.
space as like a pop-up. And
yeah.
Yep.
By the next meeting. I don't know for sure. I'm kind of holding pattern waiting for that. So I could, that could be an add-on agenda item if there is more of that, at least an update.
And if we're comfortable with Councilor Lott Klein being the liaison to the arts events promotion group, and me being the liaison to the at-risk downtown panhandling group, then following your meeting with the mayor, if in fact we then have access to Ed Keller and Brian, et cetera, then we could report back at our next meeting on the elements of these working groups coming together, the purpose of the working groups being to plan these panels that we're talking about. If indeed the working groups really find that they would be helpful. So progress report on working groups, I guess is what I'm saying.
Okay, so after I meet with the mayor, I will contact you both individually about both of those.
I know, what's
sounds like great.
Monday, the high school grounds.
We're the community resources committee, we should know what that is.
I know, let's invite them in.
So it seems to me for those two pieces that what I would want to do is kind of reach out to some of the key people and say, do you guys meet regularly? Who's part of that? And all of those questions that I brought up before, and I can bring that information back and say, you know, do you have any informal forums where you might start to ask one another, would you be interested in working with the committee and the council and getting council support for particular things?
Missing out on a party.
Okay.
And yes, that sounds right to me. And you might. Because I spoke with Suzanne back at the chamber earlier today, I know she's been talking to some of these folks and has given it a little bit of thought.
The arts people?
The arts people, the promote, you know, downtown promotion, how all that intersects. So you might want to touch base with her early on because she's been giving it a little bit of thought, I believe.
And I wonder, Chair, that, I mean, you have the on your plate to talk to the mayor, but do we have a plan for the actual write-up of the recommendations or how we're proceeding? Because is that going to fall into your...
Well, yeah, although it seems like I'm not sure we're really...
I don't know that it's clear that we need to.
That we're doing that.
Write-up recommendations?
Right. I mean, if there are some specific ones, like I think the ones that stand out are things where it's clear something should be referred to transportation and parking, like review voting zone ordinance, clarify the appeals process for parking tickets. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I feel like maybe we should wait on this a little bit and see how these groups coalesce and see if we have sort of a clearer thing that we could write up and say, like, this is what's...
I agree.
Yeah. Okay.
I think Councilor Carney needs more work.
Yeah.
What else do you want to claim on this list?
I'm so overwhelmed by the big staff that... if there's something here that we haven't touched that I can research, I'll research where liquor license revenue goes.
Great.
Okay.
So for everything that's under op-ed's resolution, pretty much except for maybe the commuter rail piece, that's all stuff that we're waiting till the end of the year and getting the Office of Development and whatever it's called, final report.
Unless, in response to Councilor Kai, your comment about Factor 1, you think because there wasn't, as you noted in your press last council meeting, whether we want to do something about that in the meantime, or whether...
Or even the local stuff, shop local. I mean, there is stuff we could do around that now, right?
Going into the holiday season.
That's true. It's a good time. I wonder if another, and if we're going with this kind of expert panel model, if it makes sense to have a bunch of that stuff, shop local, and makes sense to have some kind of expert panel there.
Jasper has been leading a, he's been doing like a monthly series at Sirius on shopping local.
Yes, he has.
So I think he, and he's been bringing in speakers, so I feel like he's doing that. Sort of ex officio.
I kind of feel like we've heard a lot of expert opinion and data, and it's just a matter of, with updated data, kind of pulling it together. When we do that, we might want to circulate some drafts to various people, but...
Mm-hmm. There's also the promoting tourism that kind of could fit around that, but...
I mean, I sort of feel like the promoting of tourism also kind of fits under this arts.
I do too.
Events.
It's kind of, yeah, like it's sort of events and like how to make Northampton even more of an experiential place than it already is, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which would bring in people.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So.
I think there's
a plan emerging. Somehow it's coming forward. Okay, so I will be in touch. I will try and set up a meeting with Mayor and be in touch with you individually so you can take your next steps, okay? All right, any further discussion about these working areas and ideas? No? Okay. Any new business? I have none, no. Is there a motion to adjourn?
I would make a motion to adjourn.
All those